Hi, I'm Sindastra, and today we're going to take a look at this thing. Yep, the GPike case. Again, it never ends. So basically, after my last video, where we did take a look at recall box, I basically fell in love with recall box. It works out of the box. It's great. You should use it. And I thought I'd be done with this case. We can move on to other videos. But actually, there's one more thing to take a look at. So basically, in my first video, in case you didn't see it, I tried to answer the question, can we just swap the Raspberry Pi 0 for the Raspberry Pi 2? The answer is yes and no. We have to update Raspberry Pi OS for it to work first, and then reinstall the drivers. In the first video, there were some issues. I did troubleshoot it. You should probably check out the video. In the second video, I got it all running. And with those two videos, you basically had instructions on getting RetroPie working with the GPike case and the Raspberry Pi 02. Now, the problem with that setup was that you had to basically download the thing, the RetroPie for the Pi 0, that thing, update it for it to run here, reinstall the drivers, and as you might imagine, it takes ages to upgrade Debian on this weak Pi. So someone pointed out to me that there's recall box, which is an alternative to RetroPie, which works out of the box. I did take a look at this in the third video. You should check that out. And it's great. I love it. And I thought it's really well polished. However, to be fair, the RetroPie build I did take a look at was really old, like 2 years old, I think, or something like that, like seriously old. And someone pointed out to me that RetroPie actually has weekly builds now for the Pi 3. And the weekly build for the Pi 3 actually works on the Pi 02, which is in here. Of course, after flashing it, you have to install the RetroFlag GPike case drivers. But that's it. You don't have to go through endless updates. You just flash it and install the drivers. And I thought, to be fair to RetroPie, let's take a look at an up-to-date RetroPie to see how it compares to recall box. All I did now was download it, flash it, and install the drivers. I'm gonna do a first time boot now. Light is on. Yep, screen works. It's expanding the root file system and rebooting in 5 seconds, as you would normally see when doing a first time boot. Now the screen looks weird. That's because the screen actually turned off but hasn't been cleared. Now it's been cleared during the reboot. Now you can see it's checking the file system. That's also normal for first time boot. So yeah, one thing I noticed about recall box is it showed a video instead of the console. Now I don't mind the console, but on a really small screen, I think the boot video makes more sense than the console, because honestly, you can't even read the text on here. It's so small. Now I admit a boot video is nothing essential, but I think it is nice to have. It's more polished, but it doesn't mean RetroPie is any worse. At least in that regard, that's just cosmetic, right? So cool, emulation station booted. To be honest, I actually did try this off camera once and it crashed. It said emulation station crashed. So I expected that to happen here too. What I did was turn it off, back on, and then it worked on second boot. But because I wanted to give you the first time experience, I actually erased the whole SD card and flashed it again. This time it did not crash, interestingly. But it's the same flashed image, so I don't know what that's about. So in case you try this and it says emulation station crashed, just turn it off, turn it back on, and it should work. At least that's what happened in my case. So one gamepad detected, hold a button on your device to configure it. Cool. Xbox 360. Impossible. Up, down, left, right, start, select, A, B, X, Y, left shoulder, right shoulder. Now, it's really hard to read, but the trick is hold any button to skip. We don't have left trigger or right trigger, so we just press and hold A to skip those. I mean, it says on the screen that that's what you have to do, but it's so small, it's easy to miss. So in case you never did this before, I thought it might help you out to know to just hold A to skip. Now, hotkey enable. Usually you have a home button like on Xbox and PlayStation. We don't have that. So we hold A to skip and press OK. Now, because we don't have a home button here, it says you didn't choose a hotkey enable button. This is required for exiting games with a controller. Do you want to use the select button default? We say yes. The select button default is basically holding select and start together. So we say yes. Yes. And yeah, that's the combo to exit the game. So we don't have any games installed here. Now, let's see if the sound works. It seems like it doesn't. That's usually when you go through the menu, it will play a little sound, a little hitting noise. So we press start, go to sound settings. Now audio device, let's try PCM and let's increase the volume to 100%. If it doesn't stick after setting it, like let's press B, sound settings, it went back to zero. What this means is the audio driver still doesn't work. I did install the RetroFlag GPEG case audio drivers and everything, but it still doesn't work with the up-to-date system, it seems. So sound is a no-go for now. But here's another thing. I really wanted to check what the Wi-Fi setup looks like these days. You see, back in the day, you would basically press Wi-Fi and it would just drop to a terminal window, which doesn't really work without a keyboard or not so well. With the recall box, which I did make a video of, you should really check it out, pressing Wi-Fi settings and trying to enter the password and everything works out of the box with a nice interface that works with the crosshair button thingy, and basically just use your controllers to set everything up. This might not work here, so at least did not work with RetroPie. So I thought maybe an up-to-date RetroPie might have a nice Wi-Fi setup. So let's try it out. Okay, that's a terminal window. Yep, it still just drops to a terminal. So yeah, Recall Box has a nice boot video. It has background music. Sound works out of the box. Now, of course, sound is not a fault of RetroPie. RetroPie is not at fault. RetroFlag just needs to release an updated driver. So let's not blame RetroPie for the audio, but at least, yeah, it's not as nicely polished, because you really should check out the other video. They have a really nice setup for Wi-Fi where you can do everything with just the controller. But with RetroPie, it's a terminal. It says you don't currently have your Wi-Fi country set in ETC on a Raspberry Pi 3 model B plus, your Wi-Fi will be disabled until you, the country is set. You can do this via Raspberry config, which is available from the RetroPie menu in emulation station. Once in Raspberry config, you can set your country via menu for localization options. Do you want me to launch Raspberry config for you? Yes, yes, do so. It actually works. I can navigate a terminal. Okay. It said localization, right? Select. Okay, maybe start. Select. X. X. Okay. Connect to Wi-Fi. Sure. What? Okay, let's try this again. A drops again to terminal. I would really like to know what the enter key is. Okay, do you want to launch? Yes. Was it Y? No, was it B? B? Localization, select. Okay, so it seems B is enter. Okay, select. Cool, it does work with the controller. It's not as nicely polished, but it works for now. Okay, let's go down to Germany. Germany. Hooray. Cool, now we finish. Okay, let's reboot. Now the screen is sad again. Really sad. But yeah, basically I thought Recalbox was just more polished, and I guess the goal of this video is to compare Recalbox, or more like take a look at up-to-date RetroPie to give RetroPie a better chance, because in my previous video I used a really out-of-date version. So let's take a look at this one instead, the up-to-date one, to compare, to give it a fair chance. But yeah, those are the three main points about it being polished. Terminal screen instead of a nice boot video. But again, that's not functional, that's just cosmetic, so that's just subjective, it's just taste. Except on a small screen, I guess the console doesn't really do much for you. The other thing was background music, which was a nice touch, which RetroPie doesn't have. And the third thing was being able to set up Wi-Fi with just the controller. So let's give this another try. Now that we set the Wi-Fi country. Okay, connect to Wi-Fi network. I think B was okay. Fritzbox, Fritzbox, Freifunk. In case you don't know, in Germany, Fritzbox is a really popular Wi-Fi router, and Freifunk is basically translates to free radio, which is a project I take part in that provides a free Wi-Fi, free public Wi-Fi. And Skynet, that's a reference to Terminator, which is my Wi-Fi. Oh. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. RetroPie is nice if you have a keyboard, because it heavily relies on the terminal. But on the GPie case, I really cannot recommend it. So I did try to give it a fair chance with an excuse me, with an up-to-date image. But it seems like, yeah, it's still not as polished as Recalbox. To be honest, I always used RetroPie, but that's because I didn't know anything else. But now that I know Recalbox, well, at least in my last video, I said I'll never go back to RetroPie. I thought I'll give it a fair chance, and it's still not as polished nowadays. Now, this is not intended as hate. I really do think RetroPie does a good job. It's nice that they provide this for free, right? But yeah, if I had to choose between the two, I would go for Recalbox, because Recalbox, nice boot video, background music, nice theme, and you can set up the Wi-Fi with a nice on-screen, not really keyboard, but yeah, you should try it out or check out my previous video where you can see that there's a nice wheel for the input and you can navigate it with just the controller. So yeah, in this case, we cannot set up Wi-Fi. Oh, we can enter random stuff. So yeah, that's too bad. Now, of course, what you can do is take out the SD card and place a config file on the SD card to enable Wi-Fi. It's known as the Raspberry Pi headless setup. On raspberrypi.org, you can find the documentation on how to set up Wi-Fi by putting a config file on the SD card, and it will automatically pick it up and set up Wi-Fi for you based on the config file. So it's definitely possible to get it running, but yeah, I don't know. I think it's not as nice of an experience as Recalbox. But yeah, I mean, it's still nice that RetroPie provides a free emulation station thing for the Pi. But yeah, I would choose Recalbox. I think I'm kind of repeating myself, so I think I will end this video here. But to recap, the point of this video was to give it a better chance at competing with Recalbox and to take a look at the image that I was recommended to use, which is an up-to-date weekly build for the Raspberry Pi 3, which you can download from retropi.org.uk. And then you just have to install the RetroFlag GPi case. And if you prefer RetroPie, that's the way to go. Just keep in mind that for now, sound still does not work, even with the drivers installed. So yeah, but to be fair, that's not a fault of RetroPie, that's a fault of the RetroFlag drivers not being up to date yet. So yeah, I guess that's it. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, and I hope you learned something or at least enjoyed the video. Oh, let's turn it off. Oh, I guess the safe shutdown script wasn't installed. So yeah, bye.